For our second Japanese doctor who's going to speak today, it's Dr. Nakayama, who's an orthopedic surgeon. He's followed the March 11th earthquake. Entered the exclusion zone in Fukushima for 3 days as a member of the government's disaster medical assistance team to rescue patients abandoned at a hospital. In December 2011, he spoke in a press conference in Osaka along with Dr. Fuse in opposition to the government policy for incinerating tsunami rubble across the country of Japan.
I'm Ken Nakayama, so I'm honored to be with you. I'm going to keep going. 3番の、内部疑惑を軽視した政策、食品基準と瓦礫処理が実施されていることを述べます。
I'm going to talk about the third point, which is the implementation of the food policies and the processing of the debris that shows or that manifests the low attention, low level of importance that the government is giving to internal exposure.
日本政府は被爆を軽視して内部被爆を認めようとしません。
The Japanese government views the internal exposure problem very lightly and does not treat it as a problem.
それを示す2つのことがあります。
There are two ways in which that is shown.
1つはこの食品安全基準。
One of them is this criteria for food safety.
もう一つは汚染瓦礫の処理です。
The next is the way that the debris, contaminated debris is being processed.
新しい食品安全基準は、お米を含む一般食品が100ベクレルパーキログラム。
The new food safety standard, which has come out, allows for 100 becquerels per kilogram of food, including rice.
水と牛乳に関しては10ベクレルと50ベクレルパーキログラムです。
And for water and milk, as you see, they are 10 and 50 respectively becquerels per kilogram.
そこでベラルーシの基準を見てみます。
Let's look at the standard in Belarus.
水は10ベクレルで、これは同じですが、主食のパンに関しては、ベラルーシが40に対して日本は100です。
They are the same with respect to water, that is 10, but with respect to their primary food, which is bread in Belarus, they have a standard of 40 versus in Japan, which is 100 in Japan.
そして乳児用の牛乳はベラルーシが37に対して日本は50です。
The milk which is given to infants is 37 in Belarus versus 50 in Japan.
私たちはこの新しい基準でも緩すぎると思っています。
We believe this is too loose a standard, even though this is the new standard.
なぜなら、循環する食品の 50% が汚染されているからです。
The reason is that 50% of the food in circulation is contaminated.
ICRP の体内蓄積のグラフを見ますと、もし、
This is a graph showing accumulation of contamination in the body.
もし1日10ベクレルパーキログラムの食品を食べ続けたら、
and it shows what happens if you were to eat 10 becquerels per kilogram food continuously. That is 10 becquerels. I'm sorry. 10. If you were to ingest 10 becquerels per day.
Yeah.
continuously.
600日で1400ベクレルに体に残留します。
1400ベクレルに600 days.
ヨリ・バンダジェフスキー先生の論文では、1400ベクレルの体内残留は約半数に心電図異常が出るレベルであると述べています。
According to data that was released by Dr.
Yuri
Machevsky,a level of 1400 becquerels accumulated within the body would result in roughly half the people dying. 半数が死ぬ。死ぬ。
心電図に異常が。
心電図に異常。That was a homonym that I screwed up. Would result in anomalies in the EKG.
ですので我々はこの基準は not that. ですので我々はこの基準は不十分であると考えています。
That's why we believe this is an inadequate standard.
で次はがれきについて。
I'm now going to talk about the treatment of the waste or the debris, the accumulated debris.
日本政府は、がれき約50億ポンド。
Roughly £5 billion, which I think is 50 million tons, but £5 billion of debris are estimated to have been generated by the tsunami.
可能であればそれを燃やして、燃やせなければ埋め立てようとしています。
What the Japanese government proposes to do is to burn that if possible, and if it's not possible to burn it, then to use it as landfill.
これは、焼却場の図です。
This is a diagram of an incinerator plant for that purpose.
島田市という焼却場で、実際に試験焼却をした結果です。
And these are the results of an experimental combustion incineration that was done at a test plant in a town called Shimada.
343,445 bequerelの瓦礫をまず、捨てます。
So we're starting out with an amount of debris that contains 343,445
becquerels. で、それを燃やした結果。
Now, once that is burned, the result is
煙突からは 111,912 becquerelが大気中に拡散した。
The release and diffusion into the atmosphere of 111,912 becquerels. Capitulate the Fukushima Daiichi accident.
放射性物質は世界中に拡散していきます。
That released material, radioactive material, then diffuses over the whole Earth.
そして出てきた灰を海洋へ埋め立てようとしています。
What they are trying to
何を埋め立てる？
灰を。
灰の方ですね。
They're then attempting to pour the fly ash that results from the combustion into landfills.
甚大な海洋汚染につながります。
Which will lead to a huge contamination of ocean water.
全く理解できない行為です。
Completely beyond comprehension.
原発事故による被害はその国だけにとどまらず、世界中へ拡大してしまいます。
So the result of this contamination is not restricted to Japan. It's not limited to Japan. It's spreading over the whole world.
以上の経験を踏まえて、世界の安全、安心のために我々が提案することは3つあります。
There are three proposals we would like to make for assuring the safety of the world in this regard.
原発放射線に関わる情報には透明性が必要であること。
First of all, that there be transparency about information that regards the nuclear power disaster.
内部被曝に注目し、診断技術や病態解明に力を注いで周知させること。
Next, we need to make spread understanding about the internal exposure and build our diagnostic skills.
原発事故は世界規模の災害となるため、世界全体で縮小すべきものであること。
Because the scale of the nuclear disaster is worldwide, we need to address it in a worldwide way.
以上です。ありがとうございました。
Completes my talk. Thank you.